Now, there can't be many TV theme tunes as recognisable as this.
Oh, come on.
Neighbours, everybody needs good neighbours.
It'd normally be at this point my dad would walk in and say, oh, not this again.
Were you glued to it? Did you love it?
You can find the perfect blend. Down at Erisborough. I did love it.
It's been on telly for more than 30 years.
Plain Jane Superbrain.
Was she your favourite?
Well, when the Kennedys divorced, that cut me deep, like many people. and Bouncer, let's not forget Bouncer. Now, Kylie Minogue, Jason Donovan.
Did you do anything else except watch telly when you were a kid?
I just have a memory for these things. Margot Robbie, loads of people were in Neighbours and went on to become household names, weren't they?
Well, now the future of Ramsay Street is uncertain after Channel 5 said they're dropping Neighbours from their schedules. Let's just remind ourselves some of the show's best moments.
Neighbours, everybody needs good neighbours. With a little understanding.
Charlene!
You can find the perfect place.
Harold! Harold!
That's when good neighbors.
Don't you touch me!
It's a proper TV kiss, isn't
it? Is that a bit much for this time of day?
We're joined now by a former resident of Ramsay Street, Julie Mullins, who played Julie Martin in Neighbours back in the 1990s. Lovely to see you on the programme.
Oh, thanks. That's brought back
some beautiful memories, I'm sure, for many people who watched Neighbours throughout those years, but also you who are on it, obviously. And what have you made of the story in recent days about the fact that it might be the end for Neighbours?
Wow, well, Twitter's been going wild.
Yeah.
I had jet lag because I'd just flown back from Australia, and 5 a.m. Sunday morning, it just started going beep, 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 and it hasn't stopped. And they're grief-stricken. And I guess that's why I'm here, because they reached out and they're just desperate to find a way to avoid the end of this institutional drama.
And had there been any whispers, had you heard any rumours that it might be coming to an end? Did you feel like it was coming?
I really didn't. I heard one little whisper maybe late last year that just some friends I knew, their contract wasn't going for quite as long as maybe it had before. But I thought that might have been a COVID, you know, let's pause for a bit, rejig the budget. But, yeah, no, so I really wasn't expecting it. And certainly the incredibly loyal fans were not expecting it, so they're heartbroken.
Because, like, I think there's about an audience of about a million people, aren't there, every day for it in the UK. And I think that the way that it was being financed was it's being paid for by a UK company to be made, you know,
probably part financed.
Yeah.
I think it's 1.5 million regular viewers in the UK. Plus, of course, it's syndicated in other countries as well, but that's its biggest audience, and then the Australian audience. But a lot of people still dip in and dip out, and they have been doing so for the best part of four decades. Mm. So they've grown up with it. I mean, many actors have grown up in it and crew. So it's family to them. So it's a bit of a rough time after COVID to potentially lose it, because it's when you need good neighbours is right now, when you're in a bubble and
Absolutely.
Can't visit anyone else.
Absolutely. We've seen already this morning so many key moments from over the last three decades. Tell me, what are your favourite bits? What have been the best storylines for you?
I guess it's either the comic stuff, the comic things. I think Neighbours really does quite well. The dramatic, where you're hosing the neighbour or running them over, you know, or there's a car explodes.
Yes.
But then the comedy stuff. And then it slides really gently into the quite domestic, homey, neighbours come in and out of people's houses without knocking on the door. You know, there's no gate between the backyards and people in the kitchen. And I loved all those scenes with the Martin family or the Robinson family, just in the lounge room in the kitchen. It's just, you know, because you're relaxed, probably like you.
Yeah.
Between takes, have a bit of a chat, talk to the camera person. You know what I mean? And then, oh, next one, I'm making the kettle and acting like a mum. You know, it's a great thing to do as an actor, to have that regular work and create a good team.
Mm. And as we said, it was a programme which, because it was so popular, it launched so many careers, particularly pop careers. You know, Kylie Minogue, Craig McLaughlin, Holly Valance, Delta Goodrum. All so many people went on to do other things as well.
Exactly. And, you know, I haven't asked all of them, obviously, because I don't know them, but the ones I do know feel quite affectionate towards Neighbours, because it was their training ground. Mm. I mean, you know, Chris Hemsworth. Wow, what a great career.
He did okay.
Yeah. And, you know, Margot Robbie and my beautiful Alan Dale, who played my on-screen dad, Jim Robinson. You know, absolutely went to America and reinvented himself, and good on him.
What was it like to be in?
Gosh, it was great to have a regular gig. You know, actors are always out there hustling for the next job. Even a brilliant, you know, say, high-quality BBC limited series, you know, it ends. And then you have to wait. Are they going to do another series of Line of Duty? Are they going to, you know? Whereas when you do get that regular work, you can have the normal things that people have on that Monday to Friday. But you do hone your craft.
Oh, my gosh, just have to comment on what we're seeing at the moment because it's really very dramatic.
Jacket. Isn't that retro?
Some great hair going on.
Oh, my lovely husband, Ian Rawlings, played Philip. He was a good mate. We did have some laughs. We really did.
A spider-inspired traffic incident, that, wasn't it? Spider on the lap. Well, listen, thank you so much for coming in and talking to us a bit about it. There's a lot of love for Neighbours out there, and hopefully somebody will pick it up.
I just want to tell you, Mark in the car park here from Oldham wants ITV to pick it up.
Right.
And Colin and a million Twitter people are saying, ask Dan and Sally if the Beeble have it back. Right. I just had to pass that message on.
OK.
Well, we're not in charge of the purse strings.
I know you're
but
not.
But we'll see what we can do.
But thank you so much for chatting.
Oh, it's been lovely to have you. Thank you.
You are watching BBC Breakfast. It is 8:59.